want to just say welcome to the life after marriage. If this is your first time with us, we want to say
welcome.
If it's your second time with us, we want to say
welcome back. This is a place where two millennial parents,
that's right, us,
and I, share practical tips on marriage, family, and parenting in today's fast-paced society.
That's right. So we just want to say thank you so much for joining us today. And on today, we want to continue on this journey called the life after marriage. Now, in today's episode, this past week, we kind of shared with you guys a little love challenge. And my wife is going to share a little more on that.
Right, so we've been focusing on the five love languages.
That's right.
This month Cinco. Of February. And so today it will be marking 10 days that we have been loving our spouses.
That's
the
right.
way they want to be loved. And I just got to say, so far we're 10 days in and we're loving it.
That's right. No, and it's been an amazing journey. Like, let me just share with you a couple things that have really happened these last couple of weeks as we've kind of taken the challenge ourselves within our marriage. Because I'll be honest with you, we are not at no place saying that we have it together. But we also love the opportunity to be able to spark love to one another. And so the cool thing about this challenge is it's so practical. And a lot of times we hear so much talk about love, but I love the fact that we can practice love. And I think we've shared that a little bit on our Instagram page. But what I want to share with you is one of the things that really helped me this week for me, these last couple of days, is being able to be intentional with my wife. Now, what do I mean by that? What I mean by that is understanding that what's her love language and how can I speak to that and how can I practice in that? So one of the things I started to do is I started to think, I was like, how would my wife love? And she did the quiz, and understanding the quiz, I was able to kind of being able to do a couple acts of
you understood.
Yeah, understood, and kind of like, you know, just kind of for one of the things that I did do is pretty much I was able to just kind of wash the dishes. And so it's one of those things that, like, literally I never thought about. I was like, you know what, let me just come in the house, let me wash the dishes. And it was a cool experience because I was able to see her, like, kind of just like her eyes began to shine and she was just like, wow, babe. Like, and I you know, something so simple as washing the dishes has been such a big part of our marriage and yeah. big part of filling my wife's love cup.
And then I also love that after he would be coming back from a long day or coming home for a quick lunch, he would come home with like a tiny little flower that he picked up from his walk to the apartment. Or one day he came up with this beautiful little like bouquet of flowers. Mm. Oh, I also remember you brought me a chocolate cupcake. Amazing.
No, but hey, I want you guys to know, guys, like, and I'm not here to say, hey, I've got it down. No. Like, this is, we're in this together.
And it's practical. It's doable.
Yes. And so I just want to just challenge you guys. You know, I know Valentine's is coming around the corner. Many of us are thinking of maybe big ways or costly ways of loving our wife. Sometimes it's something so simple. And we forget that because a lot of times we think about it too much rather than just practice it and see what small thing can I do for her today. And those little things will create momentum in your life. And so the other thing that I was able to think about is like, hey, I know she loves the fact that when I write notes to her, simple as waking up and putting them wherever is visible for her to
little
see.
Post-its,
that's it. Something that, hey, I'm thinking about you, or a text throughout the day saying, hey, beautiful, I love you. Those little things that are reminders to her that, hey, I'm thinking of her, I love you, and you're on my mind, you're on my heart. Those are the things, and understanding her love language made me be able to respond in that act. So I just want to challenge you guys that. And so just try it. And she was able to just love on me this week as well.
Right. And the way I loved on him, well, his love language is physical touch.
Oh, yeah. Come on.
Ooh, a little touch here. Hey. So, I mean, it doesn't, like, when it comes to physical touch, it doesn't mean intimacy
right away.
Like, it means, like, a simple touch.
That's
like,
right.
Just acknowledging him at church or even at work or when we're out. Just a simple, like, hey, you know, I'm here. Mm. I'm thinking of you. And it can be as simple as holding your hand. He would sometimes this past week, he had long days and he would come home and I would be like, hey, can I give you a massage?
And you know,
a
I'm not gonna say no. Hey.
You know, just helps relieve his tension and
That's
also
right.
helps fill his love cup.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, it can be easy, guys.
Right,
it doesn't
right,
have to be
right,
complicated.
Right.
And we would just want to say prioritize your marriage.
That's right.
You guys.
Yes.
It's so important. It's little steps. It doesn't have to be great big things, right, like Jonathan was saying. Right. Just take little steps and put your marriage first.
That's right. Please. Yes. And so we just wanted to challenge you guys. We wanted it not just to end here, but to continue on. To continue on this beauty of loving each other and finding ways that are practical, that are everyday, that you can love on them at the way they want to be loved. Because a lot of times I try to love her the way I want to be loved and it doesn't work. And so my challenge is, take the quiz. If you haven't done it yet, try it.
The link is going to be down below in the description.
Right. And if you try it out, give it a chance. See what this starts in your marriage. But I'm telling you, man, it's really helped and shifted a lot of things in our lives to kind of be like, hey, like, you matter to me. I love you. I want to love you the way you want to be loved. So that's my biggest goal. That's my biggest dream. That's my biggest desire for you to try it. Give it practical love. And I'm telling you, man, especially as Valentine's coming around, yo, I'm telling you, it's going to be good. Hey, but any last words you want to say, babe?
No, just keep at it, you guys. Keep at it. And stay strong. Our marriages are a precious gift that we've been given. You know, you guys one day said I do to each other.
Yes.
And through thick and thin, we can make it through.
That's right. So with that in mind, don't forget, thank you so much for coming with us along this. We are here together on this journey. You are not alone. And so thank you so much. And we continue to live the life after marriage. All right. God bless. Peace out.